Hi, I'm Torben Jansen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. This time I will show you how you can map database columns whose values get generated by the database. That might not sound like an issue, but if you don't tell Hibernate that the database generates the value, it will not retrieve it from the database and you will not see it in your application. You can annotate an entity attribute with generated to tell Hibernate that the database will generate the value of the attribute. The generation time enum tells Hibernate when the database will generate the value. It can either do this never, only on insert, or always, which means on insert and update. Hibernate will then execute an additional query to retrieve the generated value from the database. Let's have a look at an example. Here you can see an example of an attribute that maps a database column with a generated value. The database updates the last update column for each insert and update operation. I annotated it with generated to tell Hibernate that the database generates this value, and I set the generation time to always so that Hibernate retrieves the value after each insert and update operation. I prepared a test case that creates and updates an author entity so that I can show you the queries Hibernate executes. You can see the test here. I first create a new author entity, set the first name and last name attribute, and persist the entity. I then call the flush method so that Hibernate executes the insert statement. Then I update the first name attribute and call the flush method again. Okay, let's run this test and have a look at the database queries. Here you can see the SQL insert statement Hibernate executes to persist the new author entity. It's followed by a select statement that only selects the last update column. Hibernate has to perform this query to get the generated value, and it executes the same query after the update statement. As you can see, Hibernate automatically gets the generated value from the database and updates the entity attribute. You can now use the generated value in your business logic, but keep in mind that Hibernate has to execute additional queries to get the generated values. These queries are simple and don't take long, but they nevertheless have a negative effect on your performance. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about Java 8 support in Hibernate, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.